generally VLSI consists of, there is a digital part, analog part. So what is the main difference? Digital and analog. So you know what is binary, all this meaning, because digital only binary, 0 or 1. Analog, the signal will be, this is analog signal, means with respect to time.
Yeah.
It will be changed, the value of voltage, current, anything. So digital 0, 1. So I'm not telling about, so this is a just giving idea, because today we just the basic concepts we are. So VLSI, so its name is very large scale. Integration, so that thing we will discuss later. So this is a chip. So chip consists of, there is a analog and digital part. So chip, again you have to consist, what is chip? Some people will be asked. So what is the people of VLSI people, what we are going to design, or people, layout engineer, design engineer, PD engineer. So that the term they are calling. So what we are doing, that thing we I'm going to discuss. So just remember, there is a digital and analog part. So we'll go give some real time example. Suppose you are building a house. So you are planning for a building your house or home. So you need a architect. So what is the job of architect? He will give the plan. Plan in the sense, which is the master bedroom. So here plan means, in the technical term, we'll discuss about what later, floor plan. So you might have, this is the technical term, we'll compare. So without plan, if you direct a building a house, so the floor will be collapsed, the house will be gone. If without plan, you didn't consult a people, good people, those who know, those architect. So these are the people who will guide you, the main person behind the your house building. So that is, they will give you plan, that is technical term for plan. So this thing will be later we'll discuss. Then plan means, in this plan they will give you, there is called bus to all this thing. So here will be master bedroom, where should be toilet, where is your dining table, balcony. So these are the, they will tell. So this is called arrangement. So who will arrange your better? That good architect. Somebody will give you directly arrange. So that is called good architect, or a technical term, good designer, a better designer. So understand the point. So just relate what I'm trying to speak. So these are like master bedroom. So just for understand, no need to write all these things. just giving idea. So that's why I'm not writing in clearly. So anybody having doubt, you can ask me. Okay. I'll write again. So architect plan. So according to plan, he will arrange the thing. That is called arrangement. So making a house. So you're making a chip. So you are called as a chip designer. So chip designer work. They will give you allocation of some area. Okay. Plan means they will give some 100 square foot. So people are giving 2 BHK there 1000 square foot, 1700 square foot like that. Then chip also there is a area. There is x axis, y axis. So in this area, you have to make a like in this term, like architect term. This part will given to master bedroom. This is like entering your room, another room, here some toilet, like that it will be done. So same thing in chip. So you will get, this is the area. So it will be allocated to you. So there is a So there is an analog part. There is a digital part. So this is digital. Some memory. Some IO. This will be divided. Some chip, there will be no pure analog, pure digital. You will be find very less. So everywhere there will be demand of analog engineer, digital engineer. Okay. And some memory part. Memory size will be very less. Analog will be there. Digital little bit more generally. So this is I'm telling you about. General case. I will draw a big size if somebody people are worried about. So now you got idea about. Now analog memory, digital and IO part. So it has some functionality. So placement over, then we have to see about the functionality. So what is the functionality thing? So a little bit zoom it. Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, I can tell.
Sir, in that chip design, just now you wrote analog, digital, and memory. So means on the same chip there will be some digital part, some analog part, like that way, sir.
Yeah, it will be combination, mixed signal. So what is the mean of custom? So it is the combination of analog design, memory. Okay. So you will not find very purely digital. You got the point? Hello.
So means the chip can have both analog and digital part. That is what you mean?
Yes.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you.
Okay, I'll give you one example for better understanding. Suppose in pen drive. So this is your computer. So you connected a pen drive. Okay, so you have some data folder here, like 1 GB folder. So pen drive has internal memory storage, so it is like 16 GB you purchase. So you are transferring data. So how, so I'm giving example how chip are using. So it's will give you 1 bit per second speed rate, means in second how many bits of data I'll pass. So bits per second means, see, in digital, so I'm not going to that much complicated, just understanding. So here's some folder 1 GB data you're transferring to here. So you need a wire. Okay, so it will take 1 hour for 1 GB. Another pen drive, suppose in VLSI company Sandisk is there, SP are there. So that depends upon, so if that taking 10 minutes, so customer will purchase which one, 10 minute or 1 hour? You're getting the point? See, you're getting the point, or I'll repeat. So when I am a customer, so the transferring data is taking 1 hour for one computer, 1 GB data is there. So I am transferring to pen drive. So one pen drive is taking 1 hour, another taking 10 minutes. So this is the designer work. Even little mistake also, it will affect in the so this is the delay work. So I'll tell you this RC circuit, all these things you'll get to know. So what is the advantage? How to better layout? So it is just mistake. So first you tell me which pen drive will people will purchase, means customer will want.
Which store is it?
Hello? Simple answer is 1 hour nobody will purchase, because those, like, this is the same example you'll get in the, suppose OnePlus mobile charger or a Realme charger or any MI charger. So so it will, in OnePlus it will take around 20 to 30 minutes for 100% charge, but in MI or Realme or Micromax, so it will take little bit more time. So that's why this is called fast. These are the example of how people are using in different VLSI admission. I mean, chip, how if you better chip, so it will be processing fast. So these are the example. So we'll come to this thing will be later. So mainly layout. So today we have to discuss, so what thing we have to cover. So this is the starting of the class. So I'll share the PPT to everyone. So I think you people having this thing is going on now, maybe network theory and this thing will be later will be added. So some basic TCL lineup, so it will be help you in PLSI and multiple learning. So if suppose some people, so this thing will be required for basic learning. So you should have basic lineup, suppose what is the LS, PWD. So this thing you should know. But programming in layout little bit less. There is a skill language is there, so it will be a different thing. So programming will be less required for custom layout. Programming less required. Okay, so I'll discuss this thing first, then we'll get to idea what thing we are going to cover. So in this, see analog layouts is spelling. So this thing will be focused more. Opening will be come in analog layout people. Maximum, if you everywhere seen Sankalp, there is service and product company are there. So we'll get maximum in analog layout opening of an IO layout. So these two will be majorly where focus. Standard cell also will cover. Memory little bit less. This will be less focus. Because its opening is very less. So we'll take around 40 theory class and 40 lab session. And our tool will be 28 nanometer.
Sir? Yeah. Sir, the theory classes will be in morning and lab sessions will be in the evening? Or both will be parallel in the evening?
That will inform you according to you. In the group, we'll discuss this thing.
Okay. If everyone. And, sir, so this 28 nanometer means which tool, the name of the tool?
This is ICC Synopsys tool actually.
Okay.
And we are planning for Cadence also.
Okay.
Cadence 45. Initially you'll get Synopsys.
Okay.
Okay. Cadence, yes. 45. That is GPTK. Cadence also we are planning to give.
Cadence Virtuoso, right? Virtuoso Excel.
Virtuoso.
Okay.
Actually, okay. Tool thing. Actually, I want to tell if I have any doubt.
Because generally in companies they prefer Cadence Virtuoso only, right?
Yeah, in Virtuoso, that's why we'll add, and Synopsys also will add. Actually, there is difference will be very less. So whatever the extra thing, that I'll discuss. If suppose okay, you are, sir. Yeah, Virtuoso almost same thing. Some new concepts are there, so that will we add. Means if we discuss the tool in the Synopsys, I'll add that topic in Cadence, but this thing is missed. Okay, so when I'll show, that thing will cover.
Okay,
so yeah,
okay,
no need to worry. And I'm planning to watch you also. Okay, but that tool is little bit 45 nanometer. So if you 28 nanometer lower technology, generally in company they are hiring lower technology people. So you can add, this is like a lower technology. So FinFET will start in this technology only. So there is, see, before that, so there is in this market, so there's a tool designer is TSMC, one company. So they have, and Samsung. 3 nanometer tap out is already done. Tap out means it is already fabrication done. See, I'm using some technical term. If some people are not understand, fabrication, this is just a completion of the work. That is called tape out. tape out.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, this core layout classes, that is the practicals and theory, especially for the labs, do we have that classroom training facility, sir, for this batch?
Classroom, actually, sir told me, I'll inform you. We are arranging the trainer.
So means by when, sir? By when will they inform?
But it will take initially 15 days not available classroom.
Okay.
So maybe Saturday I'll plan.
Okay, sir. Means it will be informed, sir?
Yeah, that will inform because some people are not able to install the tool. Like if anybody particular facing that thing, then we'll take offline class.
No, sir, because what we were informed is if we want February, they'll provide us this classroom training facility is what we were informed prior. So that is why I'm asking if we are interested in regular classroom training, will that facility be provided?
Yeah, that will be provided.
Okay, sir.
See, in India, there is no chip making company. So all our fabrication done by TSMC, Samsung, they have own tool, but still they are using TSMC. TSMC. So this is the big company, Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company. So this is not required, just I'm giving idea. The tool you told, just I'm giving. So it's 3 nanometer. This is already tape out on 3, 5 nm. So nanometer, anybody? Okay. So nano means 10^-9. So you can understand the size of this, but generally when we are using tool, that is will be micrometer. So this thing will be tell, just understand, this is a nanometer, 7 nanometer. So what is nanometer? If somebody ask you, this is the gate length. So you have seen the MOS. I'm giving just idea, but it may, I'm not discuss that much because I'll discuss today the covering of the topic, what I need to cover. So I'm giving just idea. Somebody asked you, so what is 10 nanometer? What is 28 nanometer? So what does it mean? So what is the meaning of that 28 nanometer, all these things? So this might have studied in MOSFET. So I'm just giving, we'll discuss about this thing. You have studied MOSFET. So its size, like there is two-tier depletion enhancement, all these things that is not required. So that thing we'll discuss later. So this is just a it has 3 terminal gate, drain, source, body. So for PMOS, all these things this is required. So just I'm giving 4 terminal body. So it has 4 terminal body, drain, source, gate. Okay, let's discuss. will give clarity about this topic. So I'm just giving idea what is 7 nanometer, this nanometer meaning what is. So this is your generally drain and source at same size. So this is your drain. So this is the diagram of schematic diagram. See, this bubble means PMOS, metal oxide semiconductor. So P for p-type semiconductor. So we'll discuss this thing. So no need to worry about it. Just giving idea. This is a P plus. This is a P plus. So this is a source and drain. This is a gate. This is drain. This is source. So this is your body. So I'm not discussing why it is, and this is in well. This thing we'll discuss. Everything will be discussed. So the length of the gate. Simple meaning, and this is called active area. In this, the current will be flow. See. Okay. If anybody have just a clear concept. I'm telling. So this is a resistor. You're able to see everyone. You're able to see my the screen.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is, I'm just applying a 5 volt. This is your 5 ohm. So what is the current? I equal to so what is the current is flowing here? So this is 5 volt and 5 ohm. So this is the basic course. Okay, this is current equal to
1 ampere.
Yeah, this is everybody should tell. Okay, so now I just open this. So again, what is the current?
Zero.
So just here I am giving your 5 volt. Actually current will from drain to source. Okay, this is 5 volt. So I have connected here 5 volt supply. So this is your P plus. This is your P plus. So this is your gate source. This source is connected to ground. So tell me, what is the current will flow from drain to source? This is your N well. So some people have been doubt what is P plus NOL. That will thing will clear. Okay, so current will be zero now. Why? Because this is open circuit. So until it is created, P plus here. P plus means a technical term. This is like a
channel.
Yeah, channel. Until the channel. So this channel length is your. So this is called. The exact term is effective channel length. Effective channel length. So this channel length is called your whatever you are telling 7 nanometer, 8 nanometer, that is fixed. You cannot change this length. We'll discuss that one more. But just I'm giving idea. So this is somebody asked what is 7 nanometer technology. You are working in 28 nanometer. So this is always fixed. That is your gate length in technical term, gate length or effective channel length. So both are same. So now you come to the topic. So this is here. So first we'll complete layout design flow. So what thing will do generally? See, this is the symbol. We'll do layout. So I'll draw this diagram and better you understand. So any doubt here? Yeah. Anybody is getting doubt, please free to ask. Otherwise ping here, because somebody is upgrading of somebody will laugh, so don't need to upgrade.
Yes.
So I'm just giving the example, then what we are doing. So this is first one layout people, what they will do. That is called layout designer.
Sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you're sir, I have what, like, what is the difference between what is the difference between full custom and semi-custom, like, and like standard cell and analog layout, both these things are the same.
Yeah, I got the point what you're trying to say. So I'll give that point also. So there is a schematic designer.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I mean, just one confirmation about that nanometer technology, sir. So in MOSFET, when we want the current to flow, or when we say that the current should flow through the MOSFET, so we need that channel. Technically, that channel length or the effective length of the channel, that is called as the nanometer technology, sir, that length of the channel.
Correct.
Okay, that's it, sir. Means
actually another meaning also there. So if I, because you, I till now I didn't discuss etching. Okay, I'll discuss that one. So this is what we are using, some people or IBM. So this channel length, actually, just example, this is 13 nanometer. Okay, but they have taken, this is like a 28 nanometer effective length, assume, where this point 1 nanometer extra. So what is happening, why this is 1 nanometer extra they are taking? So this is a concept is etching. One concept is, so when they will manufacture, there is a fabrication of a chip. So this is a little bit, when we will discuss this thing will cover. So when you will discuss the fabrication concept, so at the time we'll discuss etching. So etching means they will use some material. Sometime what is happening, this is happening in lower technology only, so they will take some extra length amount. One nanometer left and right. So due to compression, because just giving an example, so have you seen the bridge? You will see some gap. Okay, every bridge. So when the hot season will come, what will happen? This will compress, expand. In summer, it will be expand. So what will happen? So when it will expand. In summer, it will be expand, and in winter, it will be compress. So like that. Even that they are using cement, all these things, even it is hard, that thing happen due to increase in the temperature. So in this case, since some cases, that is not, I am telling for every case, this is generally in lower technology, because the nanometer, you have to understand, this is a very 7 nanometer, 5 nanometer, this length is very small. So at the time, what will happen, the current path will break down. There is a chance it will be break. You getting the point? Who ask you? Or everybody is getting the point what I'm trying to say? They will take some extra step. It will not break because your channel length is very small. The current will flow within small second only, current is flowing. See, I equal to dq by dt. So if timing less, current will be fast because your channel length. So this is a covering gap. Okay, so this example I given, another example suppose. This is the time period I am telling. I equal to dq by dt. Then number of electrons or by dt. So if it is number of electrons, so time less means current would be flow more. Okay, so what is happening here? So a person is standing here, just giving a person will giving other person. So here is 2 meters, or it is like a 1 feet. So he can jump within 1 second. So if it is 10 feet, jump this place to this place to this place, it will take more time. Similarly, your channel length is very less, so within small period time the current is going very fast, so controlling will be very less. So at that time, that's where they will do, so when the fabrication will be done, so they will increase little bit area, means the channel length they will increase. That is the one concept. And next concept we'll discuss etching. So at the time of fabrication, you will get to know. So wire generally will be little bit 1 nanometer, 1 nanometer left and right side. Okay, if you have doubt, means you're getting the point, or everybody is clear? That is the channel length. Generally, whatever I told, that is the final point. But in some technology, so that is called fabrication effect. So they will increase. So that is not applicable to everyone. So this is the common thing. And effective channel length means gate length. Okay. Anybody having doubt, you can speak. Is it audible? Vishnu, Suraj.
It's okay. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What I am discussing, what is analog? Okay. So now, so layout people, what they will do? So layout designer also, some designation are there, layout engineer, senior layout engineer. So these are the designation, that is some analog designer, memory designer, and standard cell designer. But this post will be very less. So this in industry, it will take one people, means layout will take 4 people. So designers. So if designer one are there, means layout people 4 people there. So opening in layout will be more. Designer very less. And generally this designer in service based company very less will be there. In product company will be more. And in product company, what is happening? This will be hired by generally if they go to some top institute, they will go 1 year internship, then they will convert to designer. So this opening will become very less, frankly speaking. So if anybody interested designer, it will be valid, but we'll discuss this topic. See, last time one student got Samsung and as an analog designer, last batch students. So I'll tell some concept that will help you for any interview. Okay, then layout. So this is the concept. So layout opening will be more. So now about designer, what they will do? They will design a schematic. Its purpose, everything they will do. So they will design a schematic like source, drain, body. This is just a giving example. This is a just I'm giving inverter. I'll give you better, you will understand better. Okay, some people have doubt. Designer salary will be more and layout people will get very less. This is not correct. You will get good package in layout also. Depends upon experience. Now the market is 3 times, 5 times your experience package. Suppose you have 3 year experience, you will get easily 15 lakh. This channel designer people will be there for starting 8 lakh. Hike will be So it depends upon. So you should not worry about layoff. People will not get that much package. Why should you join? Now current market 3 year experience will getting 15 lakh package. Okay, so this is your inverter. So this is designer. So they will do designing this and simulation. Simulation means they will giving input voltage, output, they will measure the current voltage, they will draw the diagram whether this schematic is correct or wrong. Okay. Now layout. Layout people will do floor plan. So this is in layout it will be. So when you see the tool, you will get to know. There you will like PMOS. So this is a structural layout. So I'm not discussing whether this is connected to VDD, this will be connected to VSS, all these things will be required. So they will do floor plan. Okay. Routing, place and routing. So floor plan, placement, place means placement. So you have, this is consisted of PMOS, this is NMOS. This is a VDD VSS means you need a tap, N tap, V tap. So how to place that? That thing will be place and routing. Routing means you have to connect. So place and route. Then DRC LVS. Again, I'm telling LVS. Okay, first DRC. DRC means design rule check. So this is like a you're making a home, you're connecting brick. So this is one brick, another people you put like this. This you are using some cement, but here this one will be good. This is not good. So in DRC you will check whether it is correct or wrong. So it will identify which one is the current or wrong. You have to some rule check. So we have to follow. Suppose 28 nanometer, there is some rule is there. We have to follow. We have to follow the rule. We have not to divert that rule. Otherwise, this home is not going to build like that. Chip will not be formed. So your chip will not be manufactured without DRC should be zero. So you will get zero error. But before that, you have to, this two thing is important, floor plan and placement routing. That is anybody can do DRC and LVS. So you will take learn here the technique you how to do better floor plan. That's I'm telling you. This is the floor plan and placement routing. This is like a architect. So you are doing how better. So everybody will purchase your chip. So that is your challenging job here, floor plan and placement and routing, and DRC LVS also. So here I have wrote. So you will check, so ERC, it is an antenna. So this thing will real time you will face. So here we will see only DRC and LVS thing. And generally this ERC and antenna will be checked by PB people. So another thing is there, after layout people, one guy is PB, physical verification. So their work also there. So they will check this ERC. Antenna and some checks are there. So they are going to further, they will verify, and some test engineer. And in analog, it is called AMS verification engineer. AMS, analog mix, not digital verification. Digital verification is a different thing. So AMS, analog mixed signal verification. So these people will do test. Here also they will do test, and here after simulation also there is some test thing they will do. So you are getting the flow. I'll tell again the flow. So this is for analog chip. So you will need, so this is an analog flow chart. So in analog, you will get analog designer first. So they will do some schematic. Then they will do whether it is correct or wrong.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, this floor planning will be there in layout or in physical design, sir?
That will tell. So actually, okay, this sir. Layout, yeah. So there is no technical term digital layout. So I what is PD also I'll tell you. So this is in analog. You just understand what is the meaning in analog. So you'll get to know what is digital. This thing similar to digital, what is there. So in analog, analog designer will do schematic. Then verification engineer. They'll verify whether it is correct or not. There is a one verification work is there. Then layout people will do floor plan. Placement. Then DRC and LVS. Then again, PV engineer. But some people, some company have no PV engineer. So their layout people also do the same thing. It depends upon the company, and then again verification. So verification will be do both here, but this verification employment will be very less. So in analog chip, so layout people will be do maximum and analog designer. So these two will be do maximum thing. Okay, in this anybody having doubt? So this is same will be there like memory and IO. So when these three thing is combined and standard cell, so four thing, but memory generally is different part. Just forget about memory. So analog, IO and standard, these three combined. Okay. This is custom layout engineer. Okay, this thing we'll discuss. Now digital we'll go to. So same thing in digital. So their designer is RTL. So RTL designer they will hear. So that's why called these are front end. If somebody asks you layout, now in digital and analog layout, same work will be do by PD people in digital. So they will do floor plan, placement, routing. They have PBS, PBS one tool, physical verification tool. Actually, they don't have DRC LVS. They are doing PBS tool, floor plan, placement. So this will do PD, and they will use a. Generally, they will use TCL program. They will not do layout what we are doing manually drawing all these things. That will they will do TCL program by using they will do physical designing, and they will placement routing all these things they are work. Their main is time. Their important is settled time, all this time calculation, timing analysis. So all this thing will be done by PD people. So this is in PD because PD, the frequency, all this thing is important. Binary signal, their timing calculation is important. So this thing they will add it. Physical design people, then PV. Physical verification. So in digital layout, sorry, in digital this thing are there. So in this layout people work is not there. Are you getting the point? If somebody is asking what is the PD people and the layout people. So PD and layout is almost same, but we are doing analog domain, they are doing in digital domain, and their extra thing they are doing timing analysis. This thing is not equal. Okay.
Sir, in backend, sir, in backend, a layout guy can work as a physical verification engineer also, like. As you told in some company.
Yes, that is suppose you want to switch in company. Suppose layout people can go for. So what is the scope? So if you know layout means you can go for any layout field. So that is the first choice. Analog layout, standard cell layout, memory layout, IO layout. Okay, you can go for PB also. Generally, some PB people are changing to layout. Layout people will not change generally. This is worst case because layout is the scope is more. So you can find physical verification. That is the worst case. If you want to switch to PB, you can go for. This is the physical verification. So just now I told, so VLSI just entering is difficult. Entering, don't worry about package, just get into a industry, any company. Just gain experience. Your salary will be many. See, in 6 year experience in IT company, they are getting. See, if they are just starting salary 3.86 Infosys, then 5% hike minimum. After 1 year, you just calculate. If they switch company also, they will get 6 year experience around 8 lakh. But in VLSI, it will be 5. In some company, 4. So minimum 4. But now in 3 year, people are getting 15 lakh. 4 year, around 20. So just think, entering in VLSI is any field. Lastly. You have to any field your salary will be, even you go for verification, PB, any field, RTL, every any field, just enter. That is the point. Don't think about VLSI only PD people are getting more like that. Entering is difficult. So which field you are getting opportunity, just go for it. So this is after that fabrication, testing, all these things will be repeated. This is analog layout. See, analog layout part is RFID. So this is for, this is we are not going to cover. This is only for experienced people. They are like experience, minimum 3 year people, this thing will be applicable. So those who are experienced people, I can give some project. It will be constructed of LNA, some buck boost converter. So this is some higher class, so I'm not adding here. Okay, so digital layout is IO layout, standard cell layout. Okay, so the memory layout, these are the importance of layout. Okay, so what thing will cover? So this is KCL KVL. So this thing will be initially some basic KCL KVL. So what is technology file? We'll understand the technology. 28 nanometer tech file are there. So understand the DRC rule and some voltage division rule, RC circuit. So this is every interview they are asking this. So this will help you in designer interview. And layout also interview. This RC circuit is very important. And KVL, KCL. So this thing will be helpful in very every interview they will ask the. So I'll take a minimum two class or two, three class for this. And she must, and I'll check if everybody will be able to answer the question, then I'll stop. Some basic DRC KVL question. This might have studied in BTEC. Okay, then CMOS fabrication. So this thing we are going to cover. And it's schematic layout, antenna, EM, electromigration, ERC. This thing we'll discuss. And before starting a layout, you should know stick diagram, matching, ESD, all these things. Design manufacturing. So all these things will be discussed. Device physics. This is a diagram of a just a diode. Then fabrication. So you have the step that we are following. So fabrication in the sense how the CMOS. This is a PMOS, NMOS, PMOS. This is inverter. So how we are getting? So each step are there. So this thing will cover. Next stick diagram.
Sir, so whether we will get these slides?
Yeah, I'll say. This is just a demo. Okay. Means today is introduction class. This Saturday you will get
classes. Okay, okay. So that means we can go through these slides also.
Yeah, yeah. What we are going to cover? This is just giving idea because you will not
Understand.
Yeah, where we are going to cover.
Okay.
I'll understand stick diagram. Okay, I'll give you idea. If anybody having idea about stick diagram, or you are first time you are listening. Okay. I think nobody understand stick diagram.
Yeah, I know.
Okay. You are experienced, na? I think.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So this is just a starting a layout. You should know what is stick diagram. So this is 5 minutes. I'll give you the introduction. Stick diagram. Stick means this is a stick. By using this stick, you are completing a layout, or you are giving how to plan a layout. That is the main concept. You are planning a layout. So this is just a inverter. This is VDD VSS. Okay. So now this is your input A, output is B. So this is a bubble symbol. It's just an inverter. So this is your PMOS. So this thing we'll discuss again if you are not covered. I think in basic class they discuss about inverter, PMOS, NMOS. Anybody? Everybody attended basic class?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It is discussed.
So I think you people know. So if I giving one, so what is the output?
Zero.
Everybody is correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is an interview question only. So if I connected PMOS here, just I am checking whether you people know. So I just connected PMOS here. So what is the output it will give? Or it is wrong or correct?
Sir, it will act as a weak buffer. Like it will provide the output. Like if I apply one, then I will not get exact one. I will get something less than one.
That is VDD minus VTH.
Sir, you are not audible.
Yeah, I'm not speaking anything. Okay.
Okay, okay.
I'm just drawing. Okay, I'll tell you though. So before knowing, okay, here actually one mistake is there. You have to connect a body. So this is important of body. I'll tell you. So first concept, so current will be flow from. Higher potential to lower potential. this is the concept, you know. So how will you will use here? Suppose this is a I'm going to discuss tick diagram. Okay, we'll discuss this one. So this is actually what I'm trying to say, tell. So PMOS, so this is a PMOS. So this is, before that you should know what is. So
So your screen, it got freeze, sir.
Okay, it is not changing. You're able to see now? If I changing anything?
Yes, it is visible to me now.
Okay.
So we can see just that current and higher and that one diagram.
Okay, I'm drawing again for understanding. So this is your PMOS. Okay, so this thing I told you. So if you are giving zero, so which one is turn on? See, this is everybody should tell. Some people are not telling anything. Otherwise, you can type. See, this PMOS will be turned on. So if you are giving zero, PMOS should be turned on. But NMOS is not turned on. So why? This is my question. You getting the point?
Yes, sir. Because we need to create a channel, like in case of PMOS and NMOS. So for PMOS, channel will only be created when I apply a negative potential. That's why it will get on only by the application of zero.
Okay. This is one point you told. Okay, so another point I'll add, you will understand the concept. So this is your just this is 1000 number. Okay, I'm just giving you number. Okay, NOL. This is your P plus. This is your gate. So gate is connected to A. Okay, so this is you're connecting to 5 volt. this is 0 volt. Okay, so what I make it, I make it 5 volt here. So first condition, okay, so according to you, so Suraj, so you apply negative voltage.
Okay, no, I will apply positive voltage to create a channel.
For channel
creation. Oh, no, yeah, zero, yes, negative voltage, right?
Negative voltage.
Uh-huh,
okay, you understand the point. Okay, for everybody, those are not getting. So now, NOL, this is P plus means 100 number of, I'm just giving manually just 100 number of P are there, 100 P there. Okay. Suppose channel creation, we know this is a like north pole will attract south, that you know magnet. So if you place a positive charge, so it will attract negative charge, but if negative charge will deposit, it will not create a channel. Okay, so this is like a magnet concept. So if you have you seen the magnet, if you place magnet, so the particle, it will be opposite, it will be attract, like north pole it attracts south pole. Similarly, if it is negative charge, so it will attract positive. But here NOL is the majority carrier, P, see, NOL means N channel, n-type semiconductor more, but there are some minority carrier, please. So they will be present here, somewhere here. So it will be, even negative potential will be increased. So it will be deposited here. So channel will be formed. But even channel is formed, the current will not flow. Why? Because of the same potential. So we know current formula, voltage divided by resistance. So it has some channel resistance. So R is there. So now if you 5 minus 5, it is 0. So even if channel is created, current is not flowing because of the potential. Okay. So here it is 5 volt. See, this is normal inverter. What is that? Anybody having doubt? See, this is the understanding concept. If you are not getting means you have to tell, otherwise I'm thinking you understood. Okay, so now this is, I'm on giving the concept to PMOS. The PMOS, this always remember source. So this is source or drain. Source will be connected to higher potential, and this B less than 5 volt definitely, because there will be some drop. So we know drop means you are reducing some voltage, so you will get some 4.9, depends upon your drop. This channel is all this thing, current, all this thing, it might get some voltage, so 4.9 around. I'm just giving example, but always this source terminal always greater than drain terminal. Similarly, in MOS case, this is drain, this is source. You're getting the point? See, this is connected to ground. Ground means 0 volt. This is drain terminal. So these two concept is important. So now if I giving PMOS, again I am telling, you're getting the point. So if I connected NMOS here, PMOS here, just I'm giving compare two case, so you will be better understand. This is the second, first case is so this is your higher potential because VDD current will be flow from higher potential to lower potential. See, if it is higher potential means this is 0 volt, so current will be flow from here to there. That is the concept of the any higher potential lower potential. That is the concept I told. So PMOS, this is higher potential, this is lower potential, then only current will be drawn to here to here. Then NMOS, this is the higher potential, this is the lower potential. You got the point? But in this case NMOS, so this is your current is flowing from which side? This is your VDD. This is VSS. Current is flowing from drain to source and source to drain. Okay, people are getting, I think you are not getting. NMOS I'll tell you understand. See, I discussed PMOS, now NMOS. So in technical term, this P substrate, not P well. So this thing also I'll discuss. So for this, you applied negative potential because you, I told already which charge. So if you are applying negative, so you'll get positive. So it will not create. So now again, positive charge you will apply. So here negative will be deposit. Okay, now channel created. So you have to apply voltage. Because it will see there is a potential difference. So if it is, suppose here 1 volt, so it will see the difference in potential. So I equal to 1 minus 0 divided by the resistance, then only current will flow. Okay, so now you are identifying when current is from higher potential lower potential. Okay, which one is higher? In this case, it is drain source. So remember, this thing is important. Then you will can connect PMOS, NMOS. That depends upon your potential. So you have to check which one is the higher potential, then current will be flow. That is the concept. You're getting, or anybody having doubt? So just don't tell like 0 equal to getting 1. Yeah. So don't tell blindly PMOS will be on when you apply 0. Or NMOS will be turned on 1. Second condition you have to tell whether it is potential difference. Source drain potential difference will be important. That is the point I want to tell. You're getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now we'll come to the stick diagram. See, here also diagram is there. So this material is here. So this is the inverter. Okay. So inverter, so this is PMOS, NMOS. So if you draw a layout, so in stick diagram, how will you represent? So this is just a symbol. So it will be vary. So I'm just drawing. This is your gate. This is your, you can take any one, source and drain. See here, source and drain. So this is very important. Before drawing, always NMOS drain source here, source drain. That will I repeat every time. Okay. And why we need stick diagram, that also we'll discuss later. So this is a source drain. See, this is just a gate by using stick. This is a stick. Dot you can give for anvil. Actually, in PMOS, anvil will be there. This is dot symbol. Okay. This is common gate, that's why you can connect it to one point. So this is star symbol for contact. So contact means this is a connection. This is source is connected to VDD. So this is your VDD. See this star for connection, contact. This thing will tell what is material contact, all this thing. This is just a connection. So source is connected to VDD. Okay. Now VSS is connected to, so this will be your source. See drain and connected to common point. So this is your A, B. output is B. So this is your B. So some people are not getting. So just this is just a representation. See, before planning a layout, so when you do layout, you should know some stick diagram. Means this will use will save you your area, and means any sharing is there. So this thing will be get to know later. Just I'm giving idea. Means source drain. Yeah.
Please, sir. Please use the stick diagram. There is no representation of the bug.
Sorry.
I mean the bug. The bug is not represented in the stick diagram. The substrate.
Sorry, I cannot hear what you're trying to say.
I say in the stick diagram, the substrate is not represented, the bulk, sir. Because we just have a drain gate.
Correct. This is like a half drawing. You can tell like that. So this is just a plan. Like this will be your PMOS. This is your NMOS. Just take a rough drawing because you want to just giving idea whether I should place, and this is just a one line.
Okay, thank you, sir.
It will, it is separating your PMOS and NMOS.
Excuse me, sir. So that red color stick that you have drawn, what connection is that, sir?
This red color. This
yes,
is
sir.
A common gate. See,
okay,
this is
sir.
A gate. Actually, gate is connected one point. Initially, it was like this. So you are okay. I'll give you another case. You will understand what is the advantage of stick diagram. Okay, so before it is like this, this is your gate. Source drain you can take anywhere. This is your flexible. So I took source drain here. Somebody told I will not take this is because in this, our input is left side. That's why I took here A. Output is right side. That's it. Some cases. Okay, I will give you another example. You will understand. Anybody is writing? I can edit. I'll give you another stick diagram. You will understand betterly. Okay. Can I erase? Nobody is speaking.
Yes, sir.
Okay. You know the concept like A, B plus C, D is there. So schematic design, you know, suppose somebody will give you A dot B, C dot D, whole bar. So if bar is there, so if somebody, see dot means series. Dot means series. Plus means parallel of PMOS. So this is applicable for PMOS. So this is the concept. While drawing a, if you don't know, suppose somebody will give you directly this Boolean concept, A dot B plus C dot D whole bar. So how to draw a schematic? If dot is there, series connection of PMOS. Plus means parallel. For NMOS,
sir, for PMOS, dot means parallel, right?
NMOS. Just reverse, I forgot.
Yes.
Yeah, this is NMOS, this is PMOS, just reverse, okay. So what I'm trying to say, A dot B, NMOS series. This is for NMOS. Okay. So this is NMOS A dot B, a series. Then C dot D, also series. Plus means parallel. So this is A, B, C, D. So this is your parallel. Just reverse. Reverse means in PMOS. So AB series means AB parallel. Then CD parallel. Bubble is there because PMOS. Okay, so this concept is, I think you understand everyone. Okay, anybody doubt? This is your output, Y. This is A, B, C, D. Anybody having doubt? Or you know everything, I think. Everyone know?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So if somebody asks, this is your schematic, you have to draw the stick diagram. Okay, it will be difficult for you without giving. Okay, NAND gate I'll give. Okay, this one later we'll discuss. So this is your which gate?
NAND gate.
So just I told A dot B whole bar. Because ABR series whole bar. Okay, so this is the concept. So now we have to draw a stick diagram. So A. Before stick diagram, you have to mention this is source, drain, NMOS, drain, source. This is your A, PMOS, B, PMOS, So this is your VSS. This is your bedded. So now you have to think about. Okay, somebody will do. Okay, I'll give you 2-3 cases. Which one you have to think? So now I took blindly source drain. Drain source. Source drain, drain source. Source is connected to, so as usual, the this will be divided. This is your PMOS, this is NMOS. Okay. So now this is dot dot will be in well. So this thing I am not giving. The source is connected to VDD. Okay. This source is connected. Resource is connected. So this is when you do blindly, don't use any brain. I'm just connecting source, okay? And drain. So drain already connected. You're getting the point? Drain of the AP, this is a PMOS. Before, if anybody having doubt, I'll little bit slow. So drain is connected. Now NMOS source is connected to VSS. So you have to give the name first. Now confused. A, this is also A. This is B. This is B. I'll erase it just for understanding purpose. Okay. Now see, B source is here. So we'll connect here. Drain source. See now. That's it. This is blindly I connected. You can change the color, that is not your choice. You can put cross all these things. So this is I'm not adding. Okay. Now this drain is connected to this drain. So like that I connected. So what is happening from this drain to this source? If I connecting, how much distance I am going? If I do alternate, that is called your better floor plan. Understand the point? I will give you same concept. If I alternate here, alternate means it is my, see, I can change. This is source, this is your drain, because it is flexible, means you can change anyone. This is source, drain I change. Okay, even here also I will change. You will not find. Okay, I'm keeping this. I'll draw like this. Same concept. I didn't change any device. So this is your A. This I forgot to add. This is your A. This is your B. Because this is gate are connected one point. See this coloring, you can give any point. This is not A. So what I change here, source ID here, okay. This thing I'll tell you why I am crossed like this. This is if you use M1, M2 you can use. So this is like a different wire you can use, okay. I'm giving some other color. This is your source drain. Source, this is your drain. So all three drain are connected source. Okay. So what do you find here? See, for connecting this to this, I alternate here. Here also, this one. So this is A. This is B. So by using stick diagram, what is the advantage you are getting? See, what I use common source. Common source means one line is sufficient to connect your VDD. See, you will get more advantage by reducing area. So when you do layout, you will understand the point. I'm giving today just a introduction class, so you'll get more amazing concept. So you're getting the point. See here, for this to this, I'm coming to here. But if I alternate, just reverse it. So I come here, source and drain. So I did here, source drain. So no need extra line. So this is called routing. Routing means, so in a home, you are connecting a ball or fan. So fan and ball, if you connected nearby switch, so your money will be saving. Your area will be, you no need more wall for connecting. See, this suppose this is the your home, your fan is connected here, your master bedroom fan bulb is there. So somebody use for fan one switch in corner of a one switch, he use another ball, he use other switch from distance to 10 micrometer, so 10 feet, after 10 feet he using another switch, but he is using, is turned on fan and ball. Okay, so this is the money waste and area wastage like that. So you need a extra wire connecting. Routing means just a connection. So this wire means, suppose in line connection, electric connection, you are using some wire. How to save this wire? If you place same switch, fan switch and ball switch together. So this is like a just giving example. So you can save the area and money. So in this case, see, I just alternate, no need to extra line by drawing. There is extra. And here also, see, this train is coming. I can draw here. This is, you can do both case. So here two line is required, here one line. But here some extra line is going, that is balance. But you can switch this one. Okay. Anybody having doubt? You got idea of stick diagram? Anybody having doubt?
No, sir.
You're not getting?
Getting, sir.
Okay. No, no, if not getting also, I will revise. Okay. Then I'll go to next slide. So in this diagram, so next schematic. So this is a schematic of a inverter. So see, already I told, this is verification result will be done by PV people. Now layout people will do, it will compare. So you need a LVS and DRC. LVS means, see, some verification. LVS means it will compare their schematic and layout. If it is matching, then LVS should be zero. This is like a if and else condition. If a 2 is greater than 1, it is correct. 2 less than 1, it is false. So it will go to again, we have to do layout. This is like same concept. LVS is important. So it will compare. So it will, should be matched what is the schematic and layout. So if it is matching, LVS should be clean. So this thing will be, when you have tool, maybe Saturday we will discuss some tool related concept. So this is a template means we have to some designing concept. We have to follow some template like PMOS, NMOS. We have to follow according to rule. So that template will take from design like 28 nanometer. Some template rule will be there. Some PMOS, NMOS, inverter. So these are the fix standard cell. So we'll discuss that thing. This is the diagram. So we are using synopsis. This is the layout, how you are able to see. There is a many layer. This is a library. This is a layout. You can, we'll discuss this thing when told. Maybe next class or this coming days, we'll discuss. Then layout dependent effect was in this lecture, Pantina effect, EST, EM, WP, well proximity effect, length of diffusion. So these things are the different concept. Now secondary effect. So this is the secondary effect. Then we'll give some idea about FEMTRAC. So this is only theoretical. No tool is not supporting. Okay, so FinFET means it is less than generally 10 nanometer. All these are FinFET below 10 nanometer generally. Some higher technology maximum 16 nanometer, 14 nanometer. They are telling FinFET. Okay, so generally below 10 meter, 10 nanometer will be actual FinFET. So this thing also we'll discuss. Now some project. So what project will give you? Is the VPN will be connected. So initially we'll give you discuss your standard cell layout like AND, NAND. This is a standard cell. Current mirror. This is the analog will become op-amp, FIFO label shifter, LDO, low dropout, BGR. This is the memory, SRAM, DRAM. ADC, analog to digital converter, PLL. So PLL, it will take around 1 month. So we'll have some big schematic that also we'll discuss. And then DAC, digital to analog converter. And this is the serializer, SRT. So this will be helpful for experienced people also. Some people, those having gap, they can add some experience and put we have done. So this will be helpful. So this and DCO voltage control accelerator and DLL, delay lock loop. So PLL, DLL, this is like related. The little difference is there. That also and some real time chip project. So this is what I did in my real time chip project means what real time schematic. So that will be like calibration room, BP. Some project will be there. So we'll plan for that. So it will be last only. Okay, so every time there will be assignment material will be shared. So from today onwards, every class there will be material. So we'll be get to know. And some assignment also will be given. Okay, so any doubt, you can ping me in WhatsApp. I am in the WhatsApp group also. So I'll be there every time, even my project hours. Okay. Anytime I will be help. No need to worry. You can ping me in WhatsApp.
Sir, please share your number so that if the queries is there, then we can contact you on WhatsApp.
Okay, I'll share the number only, no need to worry. This is actually institute number. I don't want to change.
So your good name is Suresh or Nagi? Okay. Okay.
Suresh.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So actually today up to 8 o'clock. So anybody today because introduction class only. So anybody having doubt, you want to ask, or will stop the session?
So from tomorrow we will be having 6 to 8 again.
No, tomorrow maybe Saturday.
Saturday. Okay, Saturday. So means okay. So these lab sessions will be like in weekdays or only weekends?
Weekdays, I think. And for that, Dipti will take some lab class.
Okay, sir.
I'll take both only, but some help required. So Dipti will manage. So that also I'll inform. Srinivas sir will inform in the group. What is their plan?
Okay, sir.
So, next class will be Saturday.
Next class means so tomorrow we don't have a evening class.
Okay. Yeah, tomorrow will be not there.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Sir, can you please explain me like what is full custom and semi custom? Like I'm still confused.
Okay.
Sir,
full custom means this technical term full custom.
One more.
Sorry? You're telling something? Okay.
No, it's fine, sir. I'm getting it.
see, suppose forget about full custom layout means. Custom layout first it meanings means it is combination of analog IO standard cell layout. So all three generally analog and IO mainly they are combinedly custom layout. It is combination of layout means custom. So in industry they are taking only analog IO and some standard cell. So these three are taking together custom layout. Memory generally different. Okay, now full custom and semi custom. Full custom means here we'll do the design means schematic and layout both will be do, that is called full custom. Schematic and layout, if you having both knowledge, that is called full custom. Semi custom means only layout you have to do. Layout means floor plan, DRC, LVS, that is called semi custom. So you have to know about schematic means, that is the extra knowledge, then that is called full custom. So in industry generally nobody will have full custom. You got the point? Either you have to be a designer or either you have to be a layout engineer. You got the point?
Yes sir.
You have to know the schematic. Here actually we will do schematic also, but we will not do any simulation, all these things. We will take a schematic and I'll tell you the how to design the schematic, like pin. I'll get to know, so this thing you will get to know. Designing of the schematic you will know, but real simulation you will not do. That is the work of a designer work. Okay, so we'll be 80% full custom, not 100% full custom design. Okay.
Okay. So sir, in custom layout we will design like IO custom and all.
Yeah. IO
like, or standard cell.
IO standard and analog. So these three I will be main focus. Mm-hmm. Memory will be less. Memory only SRAM, DRAM.
Okay.
So starting and dynamic. RAM means random access. IO GPIO
so
is
can you please repeat?
Okay. What are you trying to say? What is IO block you are telling? Sorry?
Thing like we will make layout for IO and standard cell, and the third one is
analog, which is more important. 80% syllabus will be analog layout for us. So if you see in LinkedIn or Naukri, opening will be analog layout or custom layout. Okay, everywhere opening you will see LinkedIn everywhere analog layout. You will find very less opening like IO layout or standard cell layout. Their opening will be very less. Yeah.
Sir, custom layout, analog layout, and full custom—they all mean one and the same, sir.
No. Full custom means you have to know the schematic also. The semi-custom means you don't know schematic; only you are doing layout. Okay. See, full and semi here, full means schematic plus layout. Semi custom means only layout, and custom layout means all are a combination. Three concept. You're getting the point or doubt?
Sir, what all custom layout consists of? Schematic, layout, and
no. That is okay. Again, I'm telling there is a three concept here. One is custom. Okay, I'll differentiate, it will be clear. Custom layout, full custom layout, semi-custom layout. So custom layout means, so everywhere custom is there. So they should know analog IO. And standard cell. So here also custom are there. So these three will be there. Now, extra thing is full means schematic. In this, no schematic. Means schematic knowledge will be not there. Means you cannot design a schematic like invert. Many thing are there. So this thing you don't have any idea.
Sir, we can say that the full custom, the whole circuit is designed by the by the company. That is not does it not copy to any other circuit. And semi-custom here we are copied as standards and like AND gate, NOR gate. We can take that circuits.
Not like that. Actually, what is happening in industry? Only design engineer.
Okay, sir.
Only design engineer means they will design only schematic. So this term is not existing. Actually, people are telling full custom design layout engineer or full custom engineer. So this is nobody knew schematic and layout properly, where they don't have time. Either you have to like 20-30 year experience, you will get to know. They might have no schematic and layout. Because if you join any layout means, either you have to work as a layout engineer or schematic engineer. Both will be very difficult. It will take 1 year for project completion. Getting the point?
Yes, sir.
So this term is will be very less. Or if you either 10-20 year experience, which you will get some learning about layout and schematic. So this thing is does not exist for fresher. You cannot join as a both schematic and layout engineer. Either you have to go for design engineer or semi custom engineer or custom layout engineer. So that is the concept. So full means everything you know. Semi means you know, but only layout no. And in layout, custom means analog IO and standard cell. This is the concept. Okay, anybody doubt?
What is the IO? That is analog and standard, so we know that. That IO, input, output. IO,
input and output. Input, output means in the laptop, so you have input port pin like a pen drive for pen drives or charging. So you have some pin for giving supply voltage. That is the pin. So there is ESD also, example of label shifter. This is the example of IO and GPIO. So this project I am planning to give general purpose general IO.
Yes.
ESD means electrostatic discharge. And level shifter.
Understanding.
I'll tell you, analog means anywhere op-amp is there means analog. Very simple concept. Everywhere you will find a op-amp, operational amplifier. So I'll tell you why this thing. If op-amp is there means you will identify this is analog circuit. Standard cell means AND NOR if is there standard cell. And this is level shifter is there means this is IO block. Means if some circuit are there in an interview they will ask this is in IO, this is in analog or standard cell. So you can tell the example. Okay, still anybody having doubt or we'll stop? I'll share this material.
Okay sir, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
Very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.